We're coming to you live from Tombstone, Arizona. It's sold out Chimera Stadium. This is global warming at its finest, folks. It's a scorching 116 degrees today, but thankfully, it's a dry heat. This game is going to be a wholesale slaughter. No discounts in the MFL. The teams storm the field. The Killadelphia Evils go up against the Cardinal Sins. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
If you're just waking up wondering who put that vice on your head and filled your mouth with vacuum cleaner, dirt, and cat litter, you're not alone. After all, it's Sunday, MFL Game Day. Hey, you look tired, Junior. And Bricks, you look like they just used your head in field goal practice.
Spent all night in the ER. We ate Chinese food last night.
Food poisoning?
I wish! I got the chopsticks lodged in my ears again. You know, they should have a warning on them things.
The defender says, it's mine, and he comes away with the pick. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and ten. Man, he just laid the wood on him on that one and knocked the ball out. Second down and ten.
I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past.
Come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. First down and nine. Let's not forget the great misunderstanding and purge of 2071. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Pow! With the brain scrambler! And it's first and ten. Up a two. And that'll be second and eight to go.
Another interception.
Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it. And there is nothing in the rule book for that penalty. The ref appears to be cheating. He's just making shit up. And it's first and ten. It's a jailbreak. And the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it. And it's first and ten. This is your brain, and this is your brain on berserk. And he's
Is the game over yet? I gotta go to the vet to have him reattach my big toe to
That's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. Or steer clear of them. First down and 5.
What? Come on, man. You can't hang with me. You get my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. You understand me?
Second down and 7. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the DP could go all the way. And it's first and 10. And he fumbles it, Bricks. That was a screwed up play if I ever saw one. And that'll be second down and 4. To go somewhere, but he gets stumped after 3.
They usually stop me after 3, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. He could go.
See what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
Oh, did we get how much? Yeah.
And it's 1st and 10. Oh man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. It's 1st and 10. And he reels that one in for a 1st down to keep the drive alive. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
That was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants.
Yeah, sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the Inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
And it's first and 10.
Sure, my baby sister can throw further than that, but she doesn't have to play against goddamn monsters.
And that'll be second and 8 to go. And there's an 8-yard catch.
Chipping away with those medium passes, I like it. Like a patient prison break.
Third down and a pussy hair. Defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. And kickers practice for this kind of kick every day. Pretty standard.
Nothing standard when you got bloodthirsty mutants on the defensive line.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and 10. And a hard run there picks up the first down. First and 10. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? First and 10. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
And it's first and 10. And the ball razors through the defense, cutting in the defender in half. He broke free and has open field in front of him. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. Second down and 2.
Shot there. murderer.
Did the shock treatment work?
Well, after she killed four of the doctors and zapped her, they never bothered her again. So, yeah, I guess it worked for her.
And that'll bring up third down and 7. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But probably stupid. And the quarterback calls a sign, and the ball falls to the ground. That's incomplete.
He needs to throw it when a receiver can catch it. What's he doing?
And groundbreaking analysis as always there, Bricks.
Well, thank you. I do my part.
And it's 1st and 10. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy. Oh, mama, just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. The offense is running low on running backs. They have only 2 left. They need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, with a punishing hit. Second down and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's 1st and 10. Second down in a very lot. They'll be washing bloody footprints off the defense's jerseys after a run like that. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's 1st and 10.
Oh, man.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last 3 plays! Talk about Lock!
And it's first and ten. Refuses to go down. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Well, at least they don't have to forfeit them.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. First and ten. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
And like a monkey trying, and he's off to the races. And the defense is on his heels. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take. Well, that's a strange penalty call right there.
I'm starting to notice that this ref likes talking, and it don't make much sense.
No, but he's making a lot of dollars.
Second down and more, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
Face with a shovel, Graham?
I have, and trust me, the hit that guy just took was worse.
And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Graham, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast. And then catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's under 2 minutes. A timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And it's first and ten. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
It's first and ten. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry up ball.
I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones? Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone!
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay!
Changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Grim, can I kill him?
Oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown!
Yeah, big deal. Mr. Beeper Brains ran with a ball and didn't fall down.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
Yeah, same as Britz's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit shit.
And that'll be a boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, I mean, he was a great ball player. You know, that's really what counts.
The Cardinal sins get crushed and lose by forfeit. Someone get more body bags. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.